Ayush, good afternoon. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Good. Good afternoon. Subhiksha, enable your video. Good afternoon, Subhiksha.
Good afternoon, sir.
So how was the weekend?
It was Subhiksha. Good.
So had the firecrackers?
Yes, sir.
Did you burst the crackers?
Yeah.
Ayush, what about you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Waiting for others to join. Let us wait for another 2 minutes and then we'll start the class.
Yes, sir.
Subhiksha, I think last class we were discussing about the data types, right?
Yes, sir. Data types and keywords.
Yeah, data types and keywords. Okay, let us continue that now. So dear students, without wasting time, we shall start the class. Let them join in between. Okay. Now I'll share my presentation. Everybody, don't disable your video. That is the first thing I always tell you all. I'll share the screen. Okay, Anush, what can you see on the screen now?
C++ data types, sir.
Okay. Let us recapitulate what we have done in the last week and then we'll proceed. As I was... 1 minute. Okay, Anush, now tell me what you can see on the screen.
C++ data types, sir.
Okay. Can you send me the screenshot to the group? I want to see how exactly it looks in your display. Yes, can sir. You do that?
Yes, sir.
My interface is different and your interface is different. That's why I want to see how you people can see the display. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is how it looks. Fine. Okay, let us start the class. Don't disable your video. Okay, in the last class, I was talking about the fundamentals of C++. These are the basic fundamentals of C++. That is the introduction of C++. In introduction of C++, we were talking about C++ data types. There are two types of data types. One is primitive data type. And the second one is, can anybody answer? Second one? Come on, Lipika, Anush, and Subhiksha. Come on, recall. It is composite data type, okay? So in C++ data type, we discussed about the integers, floating points, characters, boolean, and string. So int is a data type. It can store whole number. Float is a data type. It can store decimal number. Double is a data type. It can store both, but the capacity range is more. Char is a data type. It will store single alphabets. Alphabet, Boolean data type or Boolean data type is to tell whether the condition is true or false. And the last one was string data type. It helps us to use more than one alphabet. the char can hold only one alphabet and string can hold two alphabets. These were about data types. Let us move to the next slide. Identifiers. So what is identifiers? All C++ variables must be identified with unique name. These unique names are called identifiers. Means what? See, whatever you write in the programming compiler, it is not taking. The compiler will not understand. As I have already told you, ASCII will work American Standard Code of Information Interchange. So what are the rules to be followed? What all can be used? What all symbols can be used? Let us discuss in detail in this slide. Ayush, read the rules for this.
All C++ variables must be identified with unique names. The unique names are called identifiers. The general rules of for constructing names for variables.
Go slow.
Identifiers are: names can contain letters, digits, and underscores.
One second. So these are the things you need to understand. Names, the name what you are giving, it can be a letter, a number, or underscore. You all know what is underscore, right? Show me your thumbs up. Yeah, Lipika, you know what is underscore? Okay, Subiksha, you know what is underscore, Subiksha? Huh?
No.
Fine. When if you don't know something, you are here to learn something. If you don't know, don't feel shy to ask me. Okay. Now underscore is nothing but in keyboard, left side of plus symbol, backspace, then followed by plus symbol. Then there are two lines. One is small line, and the other one is big line. Okay. So if you directly press this button, you will find hyphen. Okay, the same if you use shift and the same button if you press, it will be underscore. Means what? Underscore is nothing but, see, you can see here, bottom line. Okay, now Ayush, read the second point.
Names must begin with the letter or an underscore.
Okay, whenever you write the class name, make sure that you will not start with the number. If you start with the number, the compiler will not understand. So whenever you start with the class name, okay, or the program, it has to start with letters or an underscore. Clear? Next.
Names are case sensitive. My var and my var are different variables.
Okay, now can anybody tell how many cases are there in Word? Come on, answer. These are the basic things you should have learned in school age. Okay, I will tell you. There are 5 cases. One is uppercase. Second one, lowercase. Third one, sentence case. Fourth one, toggle case. Okay, like that, there are 5 cases. Here, names are case sensitive. Means what? Uppercase and lowercase, your compiler will treat different, because uppercase means capital letter, has got different code, and lowercase, it is small letter, it has got different code. Okay, that is ASCII code. So both uppercase and lowercase, it treats different. Okay, here you can see in the example, my var is nothing but variable. See, V is a variable, where is a variable, they have used capital letter V. So my VAR is different and my VAR small letter is different. Next.
Names cannot contain white spaces or special characters like hash, percentage, etc.
Means what? When you write the name or the class name, you should not use space. Okay. For example, circle, area of circle. So when you're given the class name as area of circle, area is separate word, of is separate word, circle is separate word. So between there is a space, two spaces are there. Like that you cannot give. You have to you should not give any space. Okay, white space is nothing but space, empty space, or special characters. So the special characters, you know what are the special characters you have in your keyboard? It might be star, backslash, hyphen, okay, full stop, comma, percentage, hash, exclamatory mark, at symbol, dollar symbol, okay, open bracket, close bracket. These are things you should not use. Clear? You should not use space or special characters in the name. Wherever, other than that, wherever you want, you can use. But in the class name, you should not use that. Next one.
Reserved words like C++ keywords such as int cannot be used as names.
Okay, reserved words like in the previous slide, I will show you. See, you can see here, there are around more than 64 keywords are there. Same names cannot be used. Okay, for example, friend, you can see here friend. So this friend cannot be used as a class name. Struct cannot be used as a class name. Case, enum, int, long, short, throw. These kinds of names cannot be used as class name or the names. So these are the identifiers or the rules to be followed to write the program. Is this slide clear, Subhiksha?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll repeat one more time. So here, first thing you need to understand is you can use letters, digits, and underscore. Second one, you should start with the letters or underscore, not the number. Third one, uppercase and lowercase, compiler will treat it as different because ASCII code is different for uppercase and lowercase different. Next one, you cannot use empty space or blank space or white space, and you cannot or you should not use special symbols available on the keyboard. The next one is reserved word. So whatever the words which has kept as a special meaning in the keyword, that should not be used as a name. Clear? Show me the thumbs up. Subhiksha, yeah. Let's go to the next one. Now, so I'm not going with your textbook now. I'm following the other part of that. Before that, I'll go to textbook. Everybody are having the textbook, right? Okay. Page number 151, integer constant. Okay, integer constant. What is that integer constant? Before going into operators, we should know what is integer constant. Integer constants are constant that have no fractional part or exponents. Now, see that you can see the example here. By seeing the example only, you can understand. We specify a decimal constant with non-zero digits. Means what? The digits which you are using in that, there should not be any zero in the beginning or in the end or in the middle. So int A, 1587, okay? Int B, -148. Int C, 0, 6, 5. Leading zero specifies octal constant, okay? This is integer constant. Next one is octa constant is what? When we specify an octa constant, we should start with, we should always begin with zero, okay? Whenever you see a value stored in the integer or the data type, beginning zero is there, means that is called as octa constant. The next one is hexadecimal constant. So hexadecimal constant, when we specify a hexadecimal constant, we should always begin with 0x or OX. So if you see this kind of value in your data type, then that is hexa constant. Next one is unsigned constant. So unsigned constant is nothing but using the prefix. To specify an unsigned type, use either U or capital letter U suffix. So you can see here, in this we are using small letter U or capital letter U. Next one is floating point constant, is nothing but the decimal numbers. Character constant is single character. Okay, string constant is nothing but more than one characters. Punctuators are the special symbols used. So punctuators are nothing but exclamatory mark used to indicate not equal to. Those all things will come in the next. Now C++ operator. Let us get inside the operators now. Now Subhiksha, read the slide.
C++ operators are used to perform operations on variables and values. C++ divides the operation into the following groups. First one, arithmetic operators. Second one, assignment operators. Third one, comparison operators. Fourth one, logical operators.
Okay. See, there are, there are still more operators. Here I have taken four operators. Let us discuss this first. And these are the important operators. Okay, C++ has got different types of operators. What is operator? Operator is used to perform particular calculation by using the symbols and the value. So arithmetic operator, assignment operator, comparison operator, and logical operator. These are the four important operators you need to learn. Keep it in mind what all I'm telling now. These are all basics to be used in the program. To use this in the program, you should know all those things. Okay. Once you are thorough with what we are talking about, then what? Writing the program is very, very easy. 1 minute. Enable your video first. I think we are only three today, right? Subhiksha, Lipika, and Anusha. Anush. Anybody else joined, Anush?
Sir.
No. Tell them not to join for next class also. Okay. I'll deactivate their Zoom account also. So, operators, arithmetic operator, assignment, comparison, logical. Let us go to the slide now. By seeing this, you should be able to understand what I'm going to talk now. Arithmetic operator symbols are plus, minus, multiplication, division, modulus, increment, and decrement. Where and all you find these symbols used in the program, those are called as what? Subhiksha? Subhiksha. Unmute yourself, Subhiksha. Hello, Subhiksha. Can you see me? Lipika, unmute yourself. Okay. Anush, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, let us take an example. For example, let us take x as 5 and y as 10. Okay. Now, x plus y, what is the value? Answer.
15.
Anush.
15.
Huh?
15.
10. Okay. Lipika, x minus y, the value?
5.
Okay. Subhiksha, enable your video, Subhiksha. X into y, what is the output? Subhiksha. So x value is 5 and y value is 10. So x into y, what is the output? What is the result?
Yes, sir.
What is the answer? Anush, what is answer?
Sir, 50.
Yes. Now,
these are the question.
See here, I'm taking x as 5, okay, and y as 10. So these are the symbols. These are the symbols called as arithmetic operator. Plus, minus, multiplication, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulus, increment, decrement. These are the symbols we use. Wherever you see these symbols, you should understand that these are called as arithmetic operators. Okay. Now, in this, generally, till now, in your student life, you might have learned addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. I think I need not have to speak much about those things. But have you heard about modulus? Yes or no?
No, sir.
Subiksha. Subiksha.
No.
Okay. No. Fine. Now, I will change the value of x and y now. Okay? I'll change the value of x and y. Now, I'll take one. Okay. Now, let me take one place for me. Okay. Now, x, I will take it, x, I will take it as 19, okay? X value is 19 and y value is 6. Sorry, y value is 6. Now, modulus operator, what does modulus operator do? Okay, now it is the symbol is division. So I'll do it 19 and division. See, I'm not accurate in mouse. So just bear with this handwriting. 6. 6, how much is the 19? Subiksha?
3.1.
So decimal is coming, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, when this situation occurs, then what you have to do is you should not divide this by decimal number. Okay, what you have to do is the nearest number you have to divide. Which is the nearest number? Lipika?
6.
Which is the nearest number which is divisible by 6 by 19?
6 threes are 18.
Yes, that is what I wanted to get the answer. 6 threes are 18. Okay. 18. What is the reminder now? Subiksha, what is the reminder?
1.
So this 1 is called as modulus operator. Okay. Normally we used to take the answer as 3 or 3.5 something. But when you use a symbol percentage, so that is not percentage in programming language. Keep it in mind. That is modulus operator. Modulus operator will do what? It always returns the division reminder. So we need not have to take the quotient. We have to take only the reminder. Clear? Modulus operator clear? Okay. Whenever you encounter modulus operator, don't take the quotient, only take the reminder as the answer. Fine? Okay. Next one is increment operator and decrement operator. I hope so that you have not heard about double plus double minus, right? Yes or no?
Why
I am been talking to you people, because it's afternoon and I don't know if you go to sleep, then how can I make you wake up? So I'm just poking you one by one. Don't go for a sleep. After 3:45, you take your pillow, you take your bed sheet and on the fan, close the door, go to long sleep till 9 o'clock. but this class don't sleep. Okay, these are the fundamentals, so you have to understand the fundamentals properly. Another 20 minutes, then I'll stop the class. Okay, now double plus, double minus, very simple. Here, for example, I have 1. Okay, 1 is the value. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, if you don't give the command, if you don't give the instruction, then it won't print. So, for example, I want to print numbers from 1 to 5. When you write, it will print only one number. Okay? You want to print all the 5 numbers, then you have to use plus, plus. Plus, plus is what? Increasing by 1. After 1, second number should print. After 2, third number should print. After 3, fourth number. And after 4, fifth number. We will give the condition when to stop. Till the condition is satisfied, this increment operator will increase by 1 every time. Whereas decrement operator, see, I will write it here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Decrement operator, after 5, 4 should print. After 4, 3 should print. After 3, 2 should print. After 2, 1 should print. Here also we will give the condition from where to start and where to stop. Hope so that modulus, increment and decrement operator is clear for you all. If you are clear, show me a thumbs up. Lipika, enable your video. Subiksha, fine. Now let us go to the next slide. Next operator is assignment operator. Okay, next slide is assignment operator. Before that, I'll erase this. Okay, so arithmetic operator, hope so that you're clear. Now next one is assignment operator. Okay, now Lipika, read the slide.
C++ assignment operators. C++ assignment operators are used to assign values to variables. Operator is equal to, example, A is equal to B, equivalent to A is equal to B.
Okay, fine. This mechanism I'll tell you. C is equal to is the operator. That operator is called as assignment operator. Okay, now we will take on value. Again, we'll take on value here. The value will take it as, 1 minute. Listen carefully. The value will take it as, okay, value will take it as A is equal to 2. Okay, now B is equal to 4. Okay, assume that A value is 2 and B value is 4. Now, 2 is stored in A, but by using what operator? Anush?
Is equal to.
Is equal to is called what?
Operator.
Which operator?
C++ assignment operator.
Yeah, assignment operator. C++ is the subject name. Now, A is equal to B. A value is 2 and B value is 4. Okay, so A is equal to B, equivalent to this one. So whatever we have value for B, it will be stored in A. And whatever the value is stored in A, it will become B. Next one is plus is equal to. So plus is equal to is nothing but A plus is equal to B. Okay, A plus is equal to B means what? A is equal to A plus B. So whenever you write like this, okay, whenever you write like this, automatically it is understood that it will become like this. Okay, that is A plus is equal to B. It is understood that A is equal to A plus B. So A is equal to A plus B. A value is 2. A value is 2 and B value is 4. So A is equal to what is the output?
6.
Okay, the next one, minus is equal to A minus is equal to B. Same goes like this, A is equal to A minus B. Okay, the next one is multiplication. A multiplication is equal to B. A is equal to A multiplication B. Same for division and modulus. So whenever you encounter this kind of operators, okay, whenever you encounter this kind of operator, these are all called assignment operator. You can notice one thing. In each operator, arithmetic operator is there. In each assignment operator, arithmetic operator is there. So assignment operator symbol is equal to arithmetic operator symbols are plus, minus, multiplication, division, and modulus. By using these two, we will write the equation. A is equal to B, B is equal to A. A plus is equal to B means it is understood that A is equal to A plus B. Again, minus is equal to means what? A minus is equal to B. A minus is equal to B. It is understood that A is equal to A minus B. These kind of operators are called as assignment operator. Now, I'll go to the next one. Next slide. Next operator is relational operator. Now, Subhik Sharif.
C++ relational operators. A relational operator is used to check the relationship between two operands.
See, you should understand what is operand here. Operand, O-P-E-R-A-N-D. Operand means right hand side or left hand side. Means what? We are checking the relation between right hand and left hand. So what we can do is we can take a variable. By taking the variable and the value, we can check the relation of these two. What are the relations? The relations are many. The relations are many. It might be, I'll show you in the next slide. These are the relations. Okay. What are the relations? Is equal to. You remember plus, plus, double plus? Double minus, double plus is increment operator, double minus is decrement operator, double is equal to is equal to. Now I have given the example to make you understand clearly, that is 3 double is equal to 5 gives us false, because right hand side is 5 and left hand side is 3. So right hand side is 3, right hand side is 5 and left hand side is 3. So when you're using 2 is equal to symbol, means what? Both sides should be same. If both side it is same, then it is true, else it is false. Clear, Anush? Okay. Now at present the situation is 3 is equal to 5. Whereas right hand side the value is more and the left hand side the value is less. Automatically it will tell you false. Now you tell me false comes under what data type? Come on, Subhiksha, Lipika and Anush. False and true comes under which data type? In the previous class, I have told you clearly about these things. False and true comes under which data type? Lipika, Anush and Subhiksha. Come on fast. True or false comes under which data type? Subhiksha.
Something starts
you
from
know?
B.
Something starts from B. Exactly, you're right. But complete that word. Lipika. It starts from B, as she said, Subhiksha said, B. Complete that word. Anush, Lipika. I think Anush is going for Google. Are you going for Google? Textbook. It is called as Boolean data type. I told you, char is for single alphabet, string is for more than one alphabet, Boolean is for true or false. So here we are checking the relation between 3 and 5. That is why we call it as relational operator. I hope so that this is clear for you. Let's go to the next one. This is exclamatory mark. You can see this is exclamatory mark followed by is equal to. So it is called as not equal to. So this exclamatory mark will change your answer. Okay, will change your answer. What is the difference between first and second? Why the first one is false and why it is taken second one as true? Come on, put your inputs here. Subhiksha, Lipika and Anush. You all are fresh in programming language, so you are taking long time. I will tell you the answer. So whenever you use exclamatory mark, means what? If it is true, Subhiksha, enable your video. Yeah. If it is true, it will tell you false. If it is false, it will tell you true. Ulta. Got it? If you're not using any symbol, exclamatory symbol, then what goes, that is the right answer. 3 double is equal to 5, it is false, because right hand side is 5 and left hand side is 3. But it's the same what we are doing with exclamatory mark. 3 exclamatory mark is equal to 5. 3 not equal to. Exclamatory mark is called not. Okay? When you use that not as a symbol exclamatory mark, then if it is true, it is false. And if it is false, it is true. It will give you the opposite answer. Okay? The next one is greater than. 3 is greater than 5? Yes or no? True or false?
False.
False. Okay, less than 3 is less than 5?
True.
Okay, greater than or equal to. 3 is greater than or equal to 5?
False.
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 3 is less than or equal to 5? Lipika?
True.
So here what we are doing, I said operand. So left hand side is one operand, right hand side is one operand. Between this, we are using operation, that is conditional operation or conditional operator. Okay. Now we'll come to the first one. First operator was arithmetic operator. What were the symbols? Now Subhiksha will tell all the symbols of arithmetic operator. Come on.
Addition. Subtraction. Multiplication. Division.
Yes.
Modulus.
And the two is there? No. Two you are leaving out. Lipika, can you help Subhiksha in this matter? Unmute yourself, Lipika.
Increment and decrement.
Exactly. Thank God you are not sleeping. I am lucky. Okay. Now Anush will tell me the second operator. Which was the second operator we discussed? Anush.
Sir.
Unmute yourself. Second operator we discussed today was?
Assignment operator.
Yes. Tell me the symbols of assignment operator. Come on, fast. Assignment operator symbol, you forgot, huh? What is the symbol of assignment operator?
Plus, plus, minus, minus.
Hey, that is arithmetic operator. Okay, I'll go back. Is equal to plus is equal to minus is equal to multiplication is equal to mod division is equal to modulus is equal to are the
assignment operators.
Now again for you only, Anush, relational operator.
Sir,
relational operator symbols.
That plus relational operator is equal to plus plus. Plus minus. Greater than is equal to. Smaller than is equal to.
Greater than or is equal to. You should add or there. Greater than or equal to. Lesser than or equal to. Greater than. Lesser than. Not equal to and equal to. Hope so that this relational operator is clear for you all. If you are clear, show me your thumbs up. Yes, let me go to the next one. Next, all ranks clear. What's the next operator? Logical operator. So here, logical operator, here in this, we are going to do logical operations. So there are four kinds of logical operators. Before that, Lipika read this slide. Lipika, read this slide.
C++ logical operators. Logical operators are used to check whether an expression is true or false. If the expression is true, it turns one. Whereas if the expression is false, it turns zero.
Okay. Now, Anush, what is the meaning of one and zero?
Number, sir.
I know that is number, man. Without knowing that number, I came here. You came here. And zero was invented by Indians only. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is that meaning, one and zero, in this programming language? I've told you this also. Come on. Keep your mind sharp, yeah? You are learning programming language fundamentals. Once you're through with fundamentals, then all the time we will be into the program. Then you will say, Amma, how much I should type program, how much I should do program. That is different way of enjoying. We fight for output. I'll tell you one thing. Once you encounter error in the program and you will be searching the errors, that I want to see in your face. That shortly we'll have that. Okay. What is one variables, and zero?
Variable numbers, sir.
Oh my God.
That A is equal to one, B is equal to
one. Oh my God. Oh, they were A. I've told you. Subiksha, one and zero. Come on, Subiksha was about to tell. Tell me.
True or false? If zero comes, it's false. If one comes, it's true.
Oof. Thank you, Subiksha.
Assuming number, sir.
Huh?
Assuming number.
Still, you're not understanding, Anush. One binary is called numbers. As true, binary number, but one is called as true and zero is called as false in programming language. And logical operation will check whether the condition is true or condition is false. Here, you cannot have both. Either you should have true for true or the second one, you should have false. Clear? Let us go to the example now. So the symbols are, how many symbols are there? How many symbols are there, dear students?
Three.
Let us go in detail now. Listen carefully. This is the fourth operator we are learning now. So the first logical operator are two and symbol. In the previous one, we used two is equal to symbol. Yes? Yes or no?
Yes,
yeah, here in logical operator, we will be using two and symbol. What is this true or two and symbol? Expression one and expression two. What is the meaning of these two expression is logical and operator. Okay. Though we have two and, we will call it as and only. The two in uppercase, that too in capital letter. Logical and true only if all the operands are true. Means what? If the operand, both the operands are true, then it will work. Let us see the next one. There are two lines there. Two lines. Those lines are called as OR operator. Okay? Expression one or expression two. So logical OR, true if at least one of the operand is true. Here, either the left hand side, I'll take pen, either the left hand side or right hand side, any one it should be true. Obviously it will be true or false, any one it has to satisfy. So most of the time we will be back of or only, not and. And is telling both should be true. Okay, both will be true when both numbers are same. Okay, but here expression changes. The expression is the left hand side is true or right hand side is true. Between these two expression, any one is true, then that is a logical OR operator. The third one is, what is this symbol called as, Anush? What is this symbol called as? Anush, unmute yourself. What is that symbol called as? In the previous operator, we have discussed on that. Lipika and Subhiksha, can you tell me what is this operator symbol called as?
Exclamatory.
That is the general term we use in our day-to-day life. But when it comes to programming, this is called as NOT operator. Means what? NOT is doing drama here. Okay? NOT is doing drama here because if the condition is true, it will change it to false. If the condition is false, it will change it to true. Means what? It will inverse or vice versa the answer. So not expression, logical not, true only if the operand is false. Okay, true. When it is true, then it will be false. When it is false, it will be true. So logical operator, there are three kinds of logical operators, and, or, and not. Clear? So how many operators we finished today, Lipika? Lipika, unmute yourself. Four, name them.
Arithmetic. Regional.
Not regional. Relational. Relational. Come on, grow up, Lipika. Relational. Logical.
Forgot, sir.
Think. See, you are in first PUC. You should not say, I forgot, sir. You have to think. You have that ability to think. That is why you are gone to college now. Subhiksha, which is the binary fourth operator we missed out?
Binary operator.
Arithmetic and assignment.
Assignment operator. Assignment operator is equal to. Okay. My dear sweet students, please pay attention. Because it's afternoon, I can understand. Okay, now let us go to the next slide. C++ flow control. If statement, if else statement, nested if statement. Already we have discussed, I feel, right, about these things. Yes or no? Yes. So this should be easy for you to understand. You should not take much time for this, okay? After this, I'll show you after this. C++ for loop. For loop we have discussed. Anush, have you discussed about for loops? There are three types of for loops. For, while, and do while. And there are three types of sequence construct. That is if, else if, and else if, or switch statement. we have discussed in the problem solving methodology. Okay, so this topic we'll take it in the next class. Today let us stop here by finishing these four operators. Okay, because if I go on telling, then this camera will be happy or this mic will be happy, but you people will not be happy. Yes or no? I said no. After 3:45 go to sleep, no issues, but now don't sleep. Okay, now out of these four operators, do you have any queries? Do you have any doubts? Any doubts you can clarify then and there, so that when we go further, you should not keep something in your mind and go further, because programming language you cannot buy heart. Okay, you should not buy heart, because it is impossible to write the program if you buy heart. You should understand all the syntax. Means here, each and every symbols, each and every words have got its special meaning. This exclamatory mark is called as not in programming. Why you are knowing? Percentage symbol is called as modulus operator. Double plus was not known only for you. Double minus you are not knowing. Double is equal to you are not knowing. See, more things you are going to learn one by one. You're going to learn more and more learning things. Okay, so for that, see, I think this chapter, once we finish, then directly we are entering into the program. Almost one by one we'll enter into the program. Yeah, Anush, first you unmute yourself.
Sir.
Any doubts on these four topics?
No, sir.
No doubts?
No, sir.
I have doubt, no man.
Sir, that assignment operators, that one doubts.
Okay, what is your doubt in this slide? Tell
Can
me.
Can I explain once again, sir?
Okay, fine. That's like a good boy. I like this kind of energetic students. Okay, even Subhiksha is also energetic. Lipika is also energetic. But one thing is, they're not opening their mouth. Be open, okay? Be talkative in the class. It will be nice for interaction. So assignment operator, the symbol is equal to. So there are six symbols used in assignment operator. Is equal to, plus is equal to, minus is equal to. See here, is equal to is in the right hand side and the operator is in the left hand side. Once you see this kind of symbol in your program, you should automatically write it as plus should come right hand side. Okay, this plus should come in the right hand side. This should come here. Okay, so this should come here. Sorry, this should come here. So what happens? A is equal to A plus B. Okay, so A will come here and plus will come here, and the position of A will be the same. Same goes with A minus is equal to also. A minus is equal to B. So what you do is push this B aside and bring A minus inside. Okay, what will happen? A is equal to A minus B. Okay, so this is also called as typecasting. What is typecasting? There are two types of casting. Okay, that is, one is implicit typecasting. The second one is explicit typecasting. So what is implicit and explicit? It will come in the coming chapters. There we will discuss. Here you learn only the fundamentals, basics. Okay, the next one is multiplication. So multiplication, A multiplication is equal to B. So push this B this side and bring A multiplication symbol inside. Okay, and it becomes A is equal to A multiplication B. So value of A is 5, value of B is 10. So 5 tens of 50. So 50 will be stored in the variable of A by using this assignment operator. By using this assignment operator. Okay, now let us come to Subhiksha. Subhiksha, enable your audio. Any doubts on any four operators? No doubts?
No, sir.
Good. Lipika?
Sir, can you tell me about these operands?
Operand is nothing but this variables. This is right-hand operand. This is left-hand operand, okay? So operand has got the value to store. Operand is nothing but the variable. We can say it as a variable, okay? Here A is equal to A plus B. So you can tell us there are two operand. That is A is the left operand and B is the right operand. So these operand can store the value. Okay, that's it. Operand is nothing but right hand side variable and left hand side variable. Clear?
Yes.
Lipika,
sir.
Lipika, your doubts or your queries on these four operand operators?
No, sir.
No? Are you sure? Okay then. What's the time now?
3:43.
It's time?
3:43.
Oh my goodness, my sweet Norbu is inside. Norbu, when did you join? Norbu, unmute yourself.
Before, sir.
Before means how many minutes back?
I think 10 minutes or 5 10, minutes.
Okay. Why were you late, Norbu?
Sir, to be honest, I slept, sir.
I appreciate your honest, but I disrespect your commitment. So which one you like, disrespect or appreciation? Next time onwards, don't be late, okay? And one more thing, dear students, whatever the class I am conducting, all are there in the YouTube, okay? Complete live class, one-to-one, you, me, Ayush, Narbu, Prabhanjan, Anish, Lipika, Subiksha, the video will be uploaded in the YouTube in my channel, okay? Please subscribe my channel, and if you have any doubts, you can go to the YouTube and see the video of today's session. All sessions has been uploaded in the YouTube channel. Okay. Have you subscribed my channel?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. Then I will send my YouTube channel link to the group. Please inform the other students also to subscribe, and you can find all my videos, okay, all my videos, it might be PUC or it might be 9th or 10th, it is there. Just go through that. If you have more curiosity, go to 10 standard videos and see how the programming is, okay? Clear? But go, Norbu, today's video I'll be uploading in some time. Then you have missed the class, you can go to the YouTube channel and check the video. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So it was nice that you were attentive, you were cooperative, and you were listening to what I said. Today we have discussed about four operators. In the next class, we'll understand about another two things. That is, if else, and nested if, or ladder, or switch, and for, while, and do while. Then we'll get into the programming section. Hope so that you understood and you are with me. Now, one thing I need to ask, your feedback on this class in the chat box. Give me your valuable feedback about my class and then exit. Okay? Start typing your valuable feedback and then exit. Okay, thank you so much, dear students, for your valuable feedback. I think Norbu gave me good afternoon. This is a good class, understood well. Lipika, it was good, sir. And Anush, good, sir. And Subhiksha, I like the way your interaction with us, sir. It makes us to be more attentive in the class. And finally, my reply was, well, thank you all. See you in the next class. Bye for now. Take care. I'll end the class. Take care. Be safe bye, from sir. Corona. Bye for now.
Bye, sir.
Enable your video and say bye to me. Bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye. Bye. Where is Anush?
Bye, sir.
Bye.